Hello and welcome to Cricketomania. This is a show where we put bat to ball and discuss everything in between. I have with me Ayaz Memon, eminent cricket wala who knows everything there is to know about the game.
Oh, I wish I knew everything. Cricket is a game which teaches you something new every day. So, like everybody else, I'm also evolving.
No. Evolving is me. I'm Shilpa Ratnam and I'm learning every day from Ayaz. And joining us on the show today is journalist, writer and author Abhishek Dubey. Alright, the big question of the day is, were the selectors unfair to Harbhajan and Sehwag by not including them in the squad for the England tour?
That's a big question actually, Shilpa, because I think on the face of it, it's a good team that they've chosen. There's a lot of infusion of young talent which has gone into the side for the England tour primarily, also for the Bangladesh tour, because Bangladesh, you've got a few key players like Dhoni and Kohli not going, so it's created an opportunity for somebody else to get in. Right. But where the test team is concerned, now I have a kind of a niggling worry about this team, which is not to do with the players who are chosen, but with Sehwag and Harbhajan being left out, because they have actually chosen an 18 member team, which is, you know, a very unconventional number.
Usually it's 15.
Usually it's 15 or 16 at best. And despite adding two more, you don't find a place for either Sehwag or Harbhajan, if not both.
Right.
Is that a signal to them that, hey guys, your careers are over?
Mm-hmm.
Or is that a signal, we need to watch a little more of your, you know, form and whatever else, and maybe you have a chance to come back? I keep saying this again, that you got about 8 months more till the World Cup, where experience can matter.
Right.
But of course, I'm not saying that you should be taken only for experience. You should perform and be in the team. I thought this England tour would have been a good opportunity to keep them in the mix, keep them in the frame of mind where they start believing they still have a chance to be part of the Indian team again.
And they both look like they had a second win with Harbhajan, you know, having great economy. I think about 6.57 he had in the IPL, 14 wickets for 14 games almost, and then Sehwag with that blazing century. So they both look like they had a fighting chance to get into the team.
Yes and no. I mean, how much do you want to, you know, kind of use T20 cricket or the IPL as a yardstick is a matter of debate.
Right, because they haven't done so well in the domestic arena.
They haven't done brilliantly.
That.
They haven't done too badly. I think Harbhajan has done reasonably well.
Okay.
Sehwag perhaps could have done better. He couldn't. But just, you know, Sehwag is the kind of player, if he gets going, he's going to win you matches.
Right, but can you bank on that, you know?
You can't. I mean, that's why he's out of the team. But my point is that you have to have, say, a bank of about 25, 27 players, keep them in the mix right till the World Cup, keep giving them opportunities, because you haven't yet chosen your squad for the World Cup, which is 8-9 months away.
Right.
And while it is great to blood the youngsters, as we should, I think we should also take a little cue from other teams which are banking on experience and senior players, because that tournament is not going to be easy for rookies.
Right. And let's get Abhishek Dubey in on this. Abhishek, your thoughts. Do you think the selectors were unfair to Harbhajan and Sehwag, or did they not deserve to be on the team?
See, as far as selectors is concerned and the team management is concerned, I think they don't have a total faith on Sehwag and Harbhajan right now. Because if you remember it correctly, Sehwag played a brilliant inning in IPL. There is no doubt about that. But in which Chennai Super Kings lost the match. But after the match, when Mahendra Singh Dhoni came for the press conference, and when he was asked this specific question about Sehwag gaining, one thing is very important which he said over there. He said, we didn't have the bowler, pace bowler, to test Sehwag today. And that was a very telling comment as far as Virendra Sehwag is concerned. Right, as Ayaz sir said, that squad for the England team is 18-member squad. But we should also remember the fact that after 2002, it's for the first time that India is playing any 5-test match series abroad. And it's a long and grueling series. And I don't think the selectors had faith on, and the team management per se, had faith that Sehwag should be there. As far as Harbhajan Singh is concerned, I think again the same lies hold with Harbhajan also, because the limited opportunity which has got, he has got in the national team in the last three years, we will see, he has not set, what you would say, Yamuna on fire. He will have to cross that threshold. It's very, very important. For the Bangladesh series also, the B-run team is going. And the two spinners which has played, both of them are new spinners. Parvez Rasool is there, another new spinner is there. So I think it's a question of faith in the, not in the abilities, but in the form of these two players.
Right. You know, we have both of your views in there. Let's also get, you know, some views from the man on the street. What is it that the public's thinking? Let's get them in on this.
I think the selectors are like unfair towards Virendra Sehwag, but I'm not pretty sure about they being unfair towards Harbhajan Singh because Virendra Sehwag played really well in the IPL.
Sehwag को लेना चाहिए.
सब young player आ रहे हैं और young को chance मिलना चाहिए और इन्होंने दो तीन साल में कुछ किया नहीं है कि इनको भी मालूम पड़े कि cricket कैसे खेला जाता है क्योंकि इन्होंने मस्करी में खेला है क्रिकेट
नहीं सही है
सही है
सही है सिंस लास्ट टू एंड हाफ इयर्स बोथ ऑफ देम हैव नॉट परफॉर्म अप टू दैट मार्क
हाँ गलत डिसीजन लिया आईपीएल में देखा हमने बहुत अच्छे फॉर्म में थे वो लोग तो उनको लेना चाहिए था
राइट सो मिक्स्ड रिएक्शंस कमिंग इन देयर बट यू नो आउट ऑफ द स्क्वाड दैट्स बीन चोजन ओनली धोनी ईशांत एंड गंभीर एक्चुअली हैव टेस्ट एक्सपीरियंस इन इंग्लैंड सो डू यू थिंक दिस टीम नीड अ लिटिल मोर एक्सपीरियंस परहैप्स
यस दैट्स माय पॉइंट लुक I think the point that being made that these two guys have not been in form and therefore they are not there. And I think Dhoni, as Abhishek mentioned, made a very pertinent remark about Sehwag not being tested by high quality pace, which has been found to be his weakness now. But I just want to like emphasize, even say where Harbhajan is concerned, you have Ashwin and Jadeja who are your front ranks or front line spinners now, who haven't really done extremely well overseas.
Okay.
They've done extremely well in India.
Right.
But in South Africa, in New Zealand, they couldn't win you matches. So,
and how's Harbhajan's record been overseas?
It's been pretty good, except the last two that he went to England. I mean, Sehwag and Harbhajan were both quite disastrous, to be honest.
Okay.
But it's been 3 years since. We can't keep saying last two they didn't play well, but that was 3 years back. So many players didn't play well.
Similar conditions?
We don't know how the conditions will be, but Tendulkar didn't play well, and Lakshman didn't play well, and Dhoni didn't play well.
So
but
not
that's
just,
not the
not
point.
Just the,
yeah, it's not just. Yeah. And Sehwag, in fact, came only for two test matches and, you know, failed there. I think, in my opinion, maybe the selectors could have chosen one for England in the squad of 18 and one for Bangladesh just to keep them in the mix. Maybe Sehwag with Bangladesh, not in the test series because you've already chosen Gambhir, you've got Shikhar Dhawan and Murali Vijay. Harbhajan could have been of value. Because Harbhajan, look, he's 33, but at this point in time, spinners are approaching or are at their peak. You know, they have enough experience. He's got 400 plus test wickets, which is a huge achievement.
And around 700 international matches, which is...
So, that's one day years plus tests. It's a lot of experience that he brings to the table. Sehwag, you could have got him back and seen how he plays, maybe against Bangladesh. If he still got that edge, see Sehwag's game was eye-hand coordination reflexes. If he's lost that little edge, the reflexes are a little slow, then obviously he's going to find it difficult against stronger opponents.
Right.
And then you get a fair idea whether he is, you know, there for the long haul or not.
Okay.
But I think, in my opinion, both should have been there in one, in, not both in the same squad, but one in either squad.
One in each squad. Abhishek, what about you? Do you think the younger players should have been given the chance to shine like they have? Or did we need experience on our side?
See, as far as Indian test team is concerned, it's a work in progress. Because so many legends have left the team in the last 2 years. And unfortunately, what has happened is that after the dawn of Sachin era, we could have felt that someone like Virendra Sehwag, someone like Harbhajan Singh, the second generation and Yuvraj, they could have held that baton. Unfortunately, that has not happened with Indian cricket. And Ayasar is very right in saying that if we are talking in terms of two spinners, that is Jadeja and Ashwin, their record overseas is not phenomenal and they have not been able to perform up to expectation, especially in South Africa and other series. Now it's a testing time for them. And now the question arises, any spinner reaches their pinnacle after 33 years, 34 years, that is the age in which they write like anything. Unfortunately, Harbhajan Singh is a legend who has taken 400 wickets. But in the last 3 years, somehow something has happened in his bowling, or you can say in his confidence, which make us to think as to whether he belongs to that place or not. So he needed a captain who should have given him confidence. I am going to back you. The selectors who would have given him confidence that I am going to back you. Since this has not happened, I think that's why he doesn't fare in the scheme of things. As far as Sehwag is concerned, some people from the board has told me categorically that time has come when he should choose a time and place when to say hurrah to the test cricket. Because after Sunil Manohar Gavaskar, he has been our greatest opener. But past is past. We need to look at the future. Maybe Shikhar Dhawan, Gautam Gambhir, and the third bowler, third pacer opener, Murali Vijay, they will be fighting for two slots over there. And maybe we will have to think about the fourth opener after the series. But as far as selectors is concerned, and the team management, Dhoni is concerned, they feel ki as far as Virendra Sehwag, his place as far as overseas and in testing condition is concerned, it's over for him.
Right, but was it a question of really empathizing with these players over, you know, balancing that out with Team India? So did they choose Team India and not the player? Do you think that it was a question of that?
It's a question of that, because see, since Sandeep Patel has become the chief selector, he has had an open mindset about everything. You saw Zahir Khan was roped in at a particular point of time. Same is the case with Gautam Gambhir, he has got his chances now. And even Harbhajan Singh was tried for a couple of series. They didn't got a longer run because they had to compete with the youngsters now. Now it depends on them as to whether they are fit enough to survive that test match to get 5 days of grueling test match to get in testing condition. Because as far as Zahir Khan is concerned, we had a nightmare with him because the day in the last series in England, we do remember last time when India went there, he had to opt out of the match because of his fitness issue. And that was many felt that was the turning point of the match. So that's why selectors couldn't bank on him. It was more the question of Zahir's fitness than his cricketing abilities. So I think they have taken a calculated call. As far as test cricket is concerned, Sehwag will have to decide when he chooses to go because he doesn't repose same sort of faith in the team management. Undoubtedly, he has been one of the legends of Indian cricket, but every good thing, every beautiful thing in life has to end, and so is the Sehwag's career.
Right.
Shilpa, it makes it seem like, you know, Narendra Modi's new cabinet, anybody over 75 years of age is not allowed to be there.
So
Zahir Khan and Virendra Sehwag and Harbhajan have all reached the age of superannuation and they can't be there. It's not quite like that.
Okay.
I think that, right, I mean, look, ultimately everybody has to perform.
Mm-hmm.
It's not there, you can't get a place back in the Indian team.
No one owes you any favours.
And also you just can't get it back on reputation, you have to earn your place.
You're only as good as your last game, is that true?
Well, not necessarily. You also have to give weightage to a certain kind of body of work that you bring in.
Right.
And you know, there is, therefore, the, I mean, I can give you countless examples.
Right.
You know, the West Indies won the first World Cup in 75,
mm-hmm.
not just because of Lloyd or Richards or Andy Roberts, but also because Rohan Khanna, who was almost 40 years of age,
okay.
played a very crucial match, a crucial knock in the final.
But is that an exception?
It's not an exception. You'll find it happening in every World Cup,
okay.
I can give you.
Okay.
In 83, it was Gavaskar who didn't make many runs, but his slip catching, or Syed Kirmani with his wicket keeping, or Mohinder Amarnath, who was in his 30s with his all-round performance. In 91-92, it was Imran Khan and Javed Miadad who were so crucial in the final, along with the youngsters, and so on and so forth, you know.
So experience does count.
Rana Tunga and Murli Tharan and all these guys who've not been rookies when they won the tournament. So my point is, in difficult conditions in Australia and New Zealand, I'm talking the World Cup, there is a place for experience. It doesn't mean it should be taken automatically,
mm-hmm.
but you know, one should keep that little room foothold open. I think that you know, to say that so and so players just finished is not, it is not borne out by history.
Right.
You know, the history of the game says there are players who've come back magnificently.
Right, and there've been some great comebacks in the past, right?
There have been.
And you know, could you share with us one of your?
I mean, Mike Hussey started playing at the age of 30.
Okay.
And finished at the age of 38 or 39.
Wow.
You know, international career. He was been playing for a long time. But you know, I mean, apart from drawing those comparisons, I think the onus is on Sehwag and Harbhajan to prove themselves.
Mm-hmm.
Unfortunately, the way I see it is, from now on, the opportunities for them are limited. The next home season begins in September, October.
Mm-hmm.
Till such time, they don't have any opportunity to play. This was an opportunity for them to, or for the selectors to check them out a little bit more.
Mm-hmm.
You're throwing the gauntlet at them. Mm-hmm. If they perform, they survive. If they don't perform, they perish completely.
Right, but what more could they have done? You know, really, they've done pretty well in the IPL, but not in the domestic arena, you feel. So where did they fall short?
See, I think it's not just that they didn't fare well. It's also about how their places have got occupied. So you've got Shikhar Dhawan and Murali Vijay, and they've gotten Gautam Gambhir, I think, quite deservingly.
Yeah, as a third opener.
So then Sehwag's options get restricted.
Right.
And you've got Ashwin and Jadeja, and you've got, you know, Amit Mishra and some other bowlers that you're trying out. Akshar Patel in Bangladesh. So you're blocking out some of the other spinners because you need the composition of the team.
Right.
My argument is only about an 18-member squad going to England and neither of them finding a place, which seems to me a little, you know, odd, quirky. You know, they could have done a little better.
Right. Abhishek, what about you? What more do you think Sehwag and Harbhajan could have done to be included in the team?
I think as far as Sehwag is concerned, he has done everything to be in the team. Because if you see the hunger part also, it's evident now. If you would have been to the Nets during the Indian Premier League, you could have felt that hunger in Sehwag's body language. Yeah. But as I said, every beautiful thing in the life has to end. He accumulated everything and that it got fructified in one particular inning. About Harbhajan, let's be very, very categorical. Harbhajan is in a certain age in his career when he had 3 or 4 years of cricket left in him. He is not that old and he's a spinner in that aspect. But somehow, if you will see the trajectory path of the Harbhajan's career, what you will see is that in the last 4 years, as Yasser was saying, all of them, be it Shane Warne, there is example of Muthiah and Muralidharan, they graduated gradually and they kept all the youngsters in their threshold. They said, Kidei, we belong to this place. Unfortunately, we have not seen this with Harbhajan. As to whether the lack of confidence of the team management on Harbhajan is concerned, this is the question. We need to delve on that. Or the fact that Harbhajan has stagnated beyond a point. Because as an international athlete, now you have to compete each and every day. Secondly, we are talking, it's question of eras. Now you play 3 forms of cricket. And there is a grueling cricket calendar throughout the year. You play IPL, you play T20 cricket, you play one-day cricket, you play test cricket. So you need to prioritize. Fitness has become a very major issue. And when the Indian team goes for the World Cup in Australia and a series before that, there will be big rounds over there. And it will be very difficult to hide any player over there. So match fitness is going to be a very, very primary importance. And that the selectors have zeroed. And this is, I totally agree with this fact. The A-team who is going to England, they are not the perfect team. Many selections are debatable as far as this team is concerned. But as far as these two legends of Indian cricket is concerned, selectors have taken a call. They need to decide about their future, and they will have to do something miracle to be in the scheme of things in the next 8 months. This is how I see it.
Right, you know, and selected or not, legends they are. So we did ask people a few questions about these two. Let's see how many they got right.
पटौड़ी तो नहीं बोल सकते
नवाब ऑफ नजफगढ़
आज के डेट में वो है ना उसका जो गोल्डन बाल है यार
बिशन सिंह बेदी चंद्रशेखर एरोप्ली प्रसन्ना लांस गिब्स नो आइडिया
मुरली मुथैया
सईद अजमल
आई थिंक मुथैया मुरलीधरन इज द फर्स्ट ऑफ स्पिनर
साउथ अफ्रीका के खिलाफ ट्रिपल सेंचुरी मारी थी इन्होंने
टीम पाकिस्तान
309 रन कुछ बनाए थे ऐसे श्रीलंका के लगते हैं
भाई जी
बज्जी टर्मिनेटर
बज्जी बज्जी
पाजी या बज्जी कोई भी
मालूम नहीं
श्रीकांत
श्रीसंग
श्रीशांत
श्रीशांत को
टाटा मारा था उनको वो याद है मुझे पर याद नहीं आ रहा उनका नाम मुझे
बांग्लादेश के अगेंस्ट में लाएगी
पाकिस्तान
वो मालूम नहीं इतने आई
गेस इट इज इंग्लैंड
Right, some funny answers coming in there. Abhishek, earlier you brought in, the point about mentoring. So, as do you think Harbhajan and Sehwag make for good mentors for the youngsters in the team?
That's a good question. See, both have been captains of their respective teams, whether it's in the Ranji Trophy for Delhi or for Punjab, and obviously for the IPL teams also. Harbhajan is captain Mumbai and Sehwag is captain Delhi. Not with too much success, I must say. So in that sense, yes, but as senior players, you know, they are very different personalities. Sehwag, for all his, you know, if you watch him bat, you would think he's the most gregarious individual, but he's not.
Fiery.
He's actually a loner.
Wow.
He keeps to himself, you know, he's got these smart one-liners that he comes up with. He's a very funny guy, if you know him well. He's a very blunt, forthright person. Mm-hmm. So sometimes he can be, you know, misunderstood or misconstrued. But he's quite funny. Like for instance, when he first came and he came with a bang, he made 100 in his first match, and he started batting like, you know, somebody who had, you know, we've never seen before. No Indian batsman has ever played like Sehwag did.
Yeah.
And somebody asked him very early in his career and said, you know, what explains your success? He says, you know, my mother gave me a lot of milk when I was growing up.
And that's how the whole Veeru's mom.
Veeru ki maan hai, dood pilaya usse. And now, you can see how much he has aged and how times have changed. That now he's saying, because of his, you know, his son is being bullied or teased in school. So now he has to score runs for his son.
Yeah.
So he's got this, you know, a sense of fun, which is, he's not a backslapping, you know, jovial teammate kind of a guy, which Harbhajan can be.
Right.
You see Harbhajan, if he
but
takes
also
a wicket,
very volatile, which
he's
could
mercurial.
Work against him. Yeah, mercurial.
He's mercurial. So he's had his run-ins with people, with fellow players and what. But I think at the end of the day, he's a very colourful personality. He's had his share of controversies. Who can forget Monkey Gate? But he's been a class act. He's, you know, you can't take 400 wickets or in Sehwag's case, make two triple hundreds without being an extraordinary player. So these have been extraordinary players. Abhishek has got a point. You can't live on the past or in the past. You can't live only on past glories. Time is running out for them.
Right.
But has time run out completely for them is my question. And I question that of the selectors.
Right. Speaking of time running out, that's exactly what's happening on this show as well.
So now I have a quiz to or a question to throw.
Right.
Yeah?
Fantastic.
So we know that Sehwag is amongst the rarest of rare batsmen who've made two triple centuries in tests.
Okay.
Who else has made two triple centuries in tests? There have been 28 triple centuries.
Oh, wow.
But which players have made two triple centuries? So
in a test?
In test matches. In
test,
test cricket.
All right.
Yeah.
All right.
So, if you know, you got some gift to offer?
Yes, we do. We have Flipkart vouchers to offer the lucky winners.
But today, June 6th, is the anniversary, so to speak. It was 20 years back that a batsman made not a triple century, not a quadruple century, but a quintuple century in a first class match.
So that's more than 500?
That's 501 not out, Brian Lara.
Oh, wow.
Playing for Warwickshire against Durham, 1994. And first man, there was Hanif Mohammed who had run out on 499. Mm-hmm. Brian Lara went ahead. 501 runs, that's a half a thousand runs.
That's
made
remarkable.
Made in one inning.
Oh, that's great. And if you have any questions regarding that, email that to us or tweet that to us at Boom News TV. And again, we have some more Flipkart vouchers to give out to you. Thank you so much for joining us, Abhishek. All right. And that's it for this episode of Cricketomania.